Starbucks has one customer pretty heated, and not over its coffee, but its cups. And specifically, it's the new holiday versions that are simply red there, kind of a minimalist look. Starbucks deciding this year to drop the reindeer and the ornaments from these cups. And a former pastor and self-proclaimed social media personality had this to say about it.
Do you realize that Starbucks wanted to take Christ and Christmas off of their brand new cups? That's why they're just plain red. In fact, do you realize that Starbucks isn't allowed to say Merry Christmas to customers? Well, I decided instead of simply boycotting, well, why don't we just start a movement? So when I went in and I asked for my coffee, they asked for my name, and I told them my name is Merry Christmas. So guess what, Starbucks? I tricked you into putting Merry Christmas on your cup.
Joining me now is Merry Christmas, or social media evangelist Josh Feuerstein. And also we have Pete Dominic. He's a political talk show host for Sirius XM Radio. Okay, so we see that clip that you have done, Joshua, in front of the Starbucks. Explain in full, though, why this year's red cup is making you so angry.
Well, I think it's much more than just a cup. I think it's the overall narrative, and I think that the cup is very symbolic and parabolic in that it parallels a society that is essentially trying to remove Christmas from Christmas. I mean, think about it. Think about the fact that South Park Mall has required that they take down their Christmas tree this year so that it doesn't offend anybody. To think about the fact that there's cities that are banning nativity scenes in front of churches because they don't want it to be offensive. And so I'm simply saying is this, as a capitalistic society, we have the ability to send messages to corporations, to send messages to different individuals that while here in America, 73% of people identify themselves as Christian. We're founded on Judeo-Christian principles. And I think that the silent majority is sick and tired of consistently being bullied to be quiet about our beliefs and essentially trying to remove Christ out of Christmas and Christmas out of society.
Okay, so Joshua, I don't know if you can see Pete, but his eyebrows have been going up and down. So weigh in here, Pete.
Well, listen, first of all, it's always fun to listen to someone who's calls himself a Christ follower tout the benefits of capitalism. But, you know, this guy is what I call an entrepreneurial bigot, Brianna. I mean, he's known before this. He's known for wanting to take up arms against gay people. He's known for trying to debunk evolution. He makes some money on the side as a Chaz Bono impersonator, which is ironic on its own. But the idea that he's going to try to get people at Starbucks to say Merry Christmas, he's only going to get people to go to Starbucks more and buy more coffee. Starbucks isn't going to change their policy, a policy that has not changed. They've never had anything on their cups that he's saying they're taking up. But if he were really a great Christian, he would maybe, he'd go into Starbucks, and there's a lot of homeless people here in New York that use Starbucks for a bathroom, a shower. So maybe what he should do to get the same exact outcome is maybe buy a pastry or sandwich for a homeless person and then wish them a Merry Christmas, and he gets the benefits of that with all that hatred and bigotry and cynical self-promotion. That's all this is, and I'm here to be the needle to pop that balloon.
Can you hear that, Joshua? Can you respond to that?
Well, unfortunately, I don't think that Pete's audio is put into my...
That's a shame.
Oh, okay, it's not... Okay, so, well, then let me tell you. Okay, he called you a bigot, and he said that the Christian thing to do would be to go in, buy a pastry for someone who's homeless, and he also
wish them a Merry Christmas.
And wish them a Merry Christmas, he said. That I will tell you, that's the condensed version. But
okay, so
respond to that.
You know, it's kind of hard for me to respond to something that I wasn't able to hear. But what exactly was his point about me being a bigot?
Pete.
Well, this guy, I mean, I'm not telling anybody to Google him, but if you did, you'd see he carries a machine gun on one of his videos and says and calls for an armed revolution against gay people. So there's a little bit.
Basically, he says he's saying that you are anti-gay and because of that, you're a bigot. But also, Joshua, I also think because you can't hear Pete, I want to ask you a question since you can't hear me.
Sure. I would love to respond to whatever Pete has to say. Unfortunately, I can't hear it. Every time he talks, it's just blank space. So.
Okay. All right. Pete, you know, no offense on that. But I want to ask
none taken.
I want to ask you about this, Joshua, because,
you again.
You know, one of the things, I know this point that you're making, But I would wonder, when you look at these cups in Starbucks, and you have Starbucks saying, you know, what we want is for it to be kind of this blank canvas for people to do whatever they wish with it. But, you know, there's also some Christmas-themed products that are in the store. I think we actually have some photos of them that we pulled up from online. Does that sort of poke a hole in your theory that they are anti-Christmas? Or, I mean, here we have coffee, the Christmas blend.
So what do you think
about that?
Okay, so the thing that they are most known for is obviously their cup, not their Christmas blend that's sitting somewhere on a bottom shelf. They're known for their cup. That's what people take. That's what people display on their office desk. And as
but
they
if
even
they were really anti-Christmas, yeah. wouldn't they so, be sort of anti-Christmas across the board?
So if you'll allow me to finish the question, I think that this has been something that has been taking place slowly over time. And again, it goes to show a much larger narrative of a society that has slowly been trying to take Christmas out of the public spotlight. And now, with this video going viral, 13 million views in 3 days? It's been shared over and over. It's a trending hashtag for the last 2 days on social media. I think that what we've tapped into here is that there is a large demographic of Christian Americans that are saying we're fed up with being politically correct and it's time to just be correct. I mean, look, if this was not a Judeo-Christian society, then why did Obama have to pretend to be one in order to get elected?
Oh, there it is. There it is. There, that's what I'm talking about, Brianna. He doesn't even have to hear me.
Okay, John,
there it is.
I have to.
We invited him on. There it is. Joshua, Obama pretend to be a Christian. Good luck there, buddy.
Okay,
good
Joshua.
Luck. He's got a Chaz Bono impersonating. Sorry.
Okay, hold on just a moment because we're having audio issues. I'm going to button this up before we go. I do have to fact check you, Joshua, because the president is a Christian. But I will tell you, I know that you've touched a nerve, and we certainly appreciate you being on. I'm sorry about the audio problems. I wish we could have a wider discussion here, but I'm going to leave it there. Pete, Joshua, thank you guys so much for coming on.